To the ground now. Shake it, make your boyfriend jealous. Shake it, make it.
Raiders, Saints, coming up on EA Sports. We welcome you to New Orleans, Louisiana, for today's game.
Phil, we've got a couple of the best tight ends in the game on each sideline today, and they could be the difference makers.
You know, these tight ends, they can do it all. They're tremendous blockers for the running game. They got the speed to go down the field, and they got feet, Jim. You know, those quick feet, so even when they run those short routes, if there's man-to-man coverage, they're quick enough and shifty enough to still get away from the defender.
This game has officially begun. Wilson's got it. Tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. First down at the 22. Looking for some daylight up the middle. That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9. Gurley's taking the handoff. And at the 25, he'll be brought down. And now, here's the Saints defense. They know they need to force turnovers today, coming off a game in which they had no takeaways. Quarters formation here for the defense. The Raiders will take the snap from the 25. Over to Graham. Graham's met at the 37.
One of the better talented tight ends in the NFL. He makes that catch just right in stride and gets a nice catch.
They come to the line, and it's first down. Mariota's lined up. Two tight ends set. Toss play. Gurley's marked down at the 41. And that's the type of run I think this offense would take all game long, Phil.
Oh, would they ever. They would love this. This is showing your dominance here. The offensive line doing a good job, but also a solid job by the running back picking up some good yards.
And it'll be second down at 6 after the running play on first down. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Back to him. Now makes the move to the right. That's a gain of 6.
The defense doesn't want to give up runs like that, so how do they stop it? Well, they start crowding the line of scrimmage, so you keep crowding that line of scrimmage. Look out, they'll throw it over the top.
It's first down as they head to the line. The Raiders go back to the ground. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day. Second down and 8. Another handoff right back to him.
If you want to run the football to success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
The offense heads to the line for the 7th play of the drive. They bring in the extra tight end. Third down and 6. That's dropped by Graham, who couldn't bring it in.
Well, sometimes when you have a talented receiver, you just got to put up with plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, it can make a big play.
Touchback, and the ball will be spotted at the 20.
The Raiders defense now is going to go nickel.
Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
Almost intercepted. Here's a look at the Saints offense. How will this team rebound after last week's debacle in which they turned the football over five times? Second and 10. Throws the pass. The ball is taken out of his hands. And now, here's the Raiders' defense. A week ago, this is a bunch that forced five turnovers.
Third down following the incompletion.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Out of the gun. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab. First down, about 3.5 minutes to go here in the first. The Saints are at the line of scrimmage with a spread formation. Cleaners got it. Ball at the 47.
Get ready.
Now first and 10. We'll go ground. Spiller out to the right. Second down coming up.
The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
Cooks got it on a pass that had some heat.
Well, he's got talent. This receiver can make the catches when you throw it his way. And I think his talent, the way offenses are designed and the rules of the NFL, it makes guys like him almost unstoppable.
Line of scrimmage, the 27.
First down here after the completion.
Snap it out of the gun. Should have had it, but the hit knocked it out.
Good anticipation that time by the defender. He gets to the receiver just as the football is arriving, and he makes a beautiful hit to knock the football loose.
Second down and 10. Spiller's going to take the handoff now. He's going to be tackled right around the 24-yard line. And following that penalty, it sets up second down and 17. Takes it from the gun. Under fire on that throw.
Just stick the football on him. When you see a receiver run a route like this, they're going to the corner, drive it, throw it on the line drive, so that way there can't be a mistake.
Failing to connect there, third down.
The Saints come out in a bunch set. They'll hike it to him out of the shotgun. Going for the deep ball. Incomplete, almost going in the other direction.
The Saints put themselves in a situation where the defense has all the advantage. They know the pass probably has to go down the field on third and long, and they were ready for it.
He'll try this one from 51. The Saints had a fourth down play coming up, but want to be sure about what they want to do here, so they burn a timeout.
They're in punting formation.
Yeah. just flipped field position thanks to that punt, and now the offense is really backed into a corner. The Raiders stalled on their last drive, forced a punt, so now the offense comes back out onto the field.
Yeah, they're coming back out. They lack confidence, and I understand why. They came out, couldn't get anything done. The defense was flying around making the plays. They got to change the tempo of this game.
Mariota is standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. On the money. That's a gain of six.
When you run that drag route across the field, it is not as easy as it looks. You're running fast. You have to catch the football right in stride, and you cannot see what's in front of you.
Gets the handle here. The Raiders facing third down. A week ago, they were not up to the challenge.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
Playing press coverage to the outside. Third down and four. Beckham has got the catch and the first. That's his first reception today.
My gosh, the wide receivers in the NFL now, it's incredible. It's not that you have one. Every team has two and three, and some have four. Good job that time by him hauling in that pass.
We're back here getting ready for the second quarter. Phil, that was a defensive tug of war the first quarter.
It sure was, and it was a tug of war, and it was boring. That's what it looked like. I want to give the defense some credit. I thought they did well, but really the offense is just poor play selection, poor execution, and you got to get some emotion going out there on the offensive side.
It's a two tight end formation. The second quarter is underway with this snap. Locked in on the football and has hold of it with two hands.
As I look at all these great tight ends in the NFL now, it makes me think of the NBA. These are power forwards who said, to heck with that. They want to be pass catchers, and they're good at it.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. A timeout charge to the offensive unit. First down coming up. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. And the flag is down. The defense accepts the penalty.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
They come to the line of scrimmage. First down.
Get ready.
The quarterback motions the wide receiver.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Well, when you keep chipping away with these short throws, sooner or later that defense is going to come up. And when they come up, that's when you throw it over the top.
Mariota's now completed four in a row. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. The Raiders come to the line with a bunch set. Second down and 13. Mariota's met at the 44.
Well, I think it's important for the defense. Anytime it's a third long situation for the offense, to know where those first down markers are, give a little ground, and make sure you're able to come up and make the tackle short of the first down marker.
It's third down coming up. Looks like they're in press coverage here.
Let's go.
The Raiders have it at the 44. It's intercepted! A foot race to the end zone. The 20. The 10. They bring him to the turf. And Phil, they pick the football off in the end zone.
I give the defense all the credit. What a good job by them diagnosing the play, reading the quarterback's eyes, and making the interception.
The offense coming to the line inside the opponent's 20. First and goal. And he's across for the touchdown. And here in quarter number two, they've taken the lead with that touchdown.
Yeah, the offensive coordinator, boy, he's got to be happy with the play calls and the execution by the players on the offensive side. That was a good, smart drive.
The Saints are ready to kick it away. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Raiders are set to take the field again on offense after a crazy sequence that didn't go their way. That turnover led to turnover points. And now let's see if the offense can get that back, Phil.
Yeah, listen, I know they're going to be motivated because after they turned the football over last time, the coaches took them to the sideline and just gave them heck, that's for sure. That's a good way of seeing it. So motivation, can't make those kind of mistakes. You've got to go out there and be much better.
Let's go.
Mariota's going to take it from the gun. Graham with the grab.
There is nothing like having a great tight end on your offense now. There's so many things you can do with them. Remember, they're in the middle of the field. They can go down the middle. They can go outside. They can go short. They can go across. They can go out. It's tough to cover the tight ends in this league now.
Looking across the middle. Needs to pick up the first here on third down after that incompletion. The Raiders come out. Jumbo package on the field. Reese is going to secure the handoff. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line. They're set to punt it away now. Looking to make a difference. Reese is there to take it down. And a run back of about 11. The Saints back on the field on offense. They've got to be pleased with the way their offense took shape on that previous drive, which went all the way for a touchdown.
Yeah, their calling card has always been the fact that they like to do both things. They're very conscious of running the football to keep a defense honest. They did that in the last drive, and then they take advantage of the fact they're running it well, and then they play action pass or drop back. They get good protection, and they make it happen.
Boy, it's been a good mix so far, both the pass and run.
Yeah, that's what you want. You want to mix it up, keep that defense thinking, and that's when it works the best. Jim, look at that. The defensive line now shifting to the right.
Draw. Lynches all over that offense and brings him down.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Second down and 11. Launching it deep. And it's incomplete.
Well, but it's third long. I just say this, be very careful on the offensive side.
That last pass incomplete, and it brings up third down. Ingram, solo back set. Coleman's there to catch a ball that had a lot of heat on it. Set up now at the 42. First down at the 42. It's complete over to Brandon Cooks. That is how you draw it up, isn't it, Phil?
Oh, man, the quarterback loves guys that can make catches like this, and they're just so strong. They know how to zero in. They never lose concentration, and you never see them drop a pass.
First down on the way. They'll call on the services of C.J. Spiller. All set up now at the 21. Second and eight. He'll throw it over the middle. Cleaner has the catch. The offense picks up another first down and extends this drive.
They are, Jim. They're marching down the field, and I give all the credit to the offensive line. They are dominating the defense right now.
From inside the red zone. First down following the long play. Keeps it. Runs it across for the score. Touchdown.
That was a nice job by the quarterback. He read the defense. He realized there was a little weakness on one spot. He goes there and gets the touchdown on the quarterback sneak.
The Raiders ready to return the kickoff. Wilson's going to test the coverage this time. Vaccaro on the tackle. The Raiders' offense is on the field, hoping to erase the memory of their last drive, which was completely unproductive, a quick three and out.
Yeah, it was. I don't know if they can erase this defense. This defense is pretty good. We saw that in the last drive, and they got good players, and they're pretty excited, so this is going to be tough on the offense.
The Raiders have it at the 39. This would be ruled incomplete. Didn't get the feet down.
That was an incomplete pass that time against cover two, the two deep safeties, and you really want to throw the football down the middle or deep down the sidelines. That time the quarterback didn't do that, and that's why it was incomplete.
Two tight ends on the field here. The Raiders have it at the 39. And looking underneath, this will go incomplete.
The defense has really done a good job here in this drive. They got this offense in a third and long situation. Let's see if they can convert it.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. The Raiders lined up, bunch formation from the gun. Has space. All set to punt here. We'll see what he can do here. Freeland's the one who brings him to the ground. the Saints ready to go on the march again, and that's exactly what they've been doing here lately. They've taken it all the way down the field on the last two possessions for touchdowns. Phil, can they make it three straight?
Let me say this to you, Jim. It's just not that easy. As we're watching this game and how they're playing on the offensive side, they make it look easy, but trust me, I was down there one time. It's a hard job.
And it's batted down. Second down after the incompletion.
I think these linebackers are moving around because they're going to try to blitz the quarterback.
Going for the home run. On target. The Saints decide to take a timeout here, leaving them with only one. First down here. That long gain sets them up here on this play. Dropping back now into the shotgun. Comes down with, oh, the defender tips it out.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
Coming up, second down.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
No room to complete that one.
I'll say this. In a situation like this, third and long, when you're winning here, if you throw the football, fire the coach. And I'm just saying that because I don't think there's any chance they're going to throw the football in this situation.
The Raiders with two extra defensive backs in the dime. Away.
The Saints really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third and long. Of course, the defense is looking for passes down the field. They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete.
Didn't have the distance. Interesting little chess match game here as they miss the long field goal and set up the opponents now with an excellent starting point.
Anytime you talk about a long field goal, it's 50-50 at best. That time, the mechanics of the situation were not perfect. Doesn't look like a good hold, and that's why they missed.
Down the field. And he knocks the ball out of his hands. That'll do it for the second quarter here in the Crescent City. And we'll take a break for halftime before returning for the third quarter. The second half is officially underway. Going to be a penalty here. For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. And it's knocked down. Second down following that incompletion. Spiller in the backfield, single back set. He rips it right out of the wide receiver's hands.
Well, Jim Nance, even you could coach a team in a situation like this. You're winning big. It's third and long. You know what you do? You hand the football off and you punt the football.
Quarters formation here for the defense. The Saints take it from the 43. That's been the story of this game. Another third down conversion to move the chains. Scrimmage, the 36. Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. C.J. Spiller. Greenland's going to make the tackle.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
After running it, it's second down. From the shotgun. throws the pass. It's caught by Cooks.
That's what you want to do. Just get a first down, especially when you're on top. Keep the clock moving. Keep the defense guessing. Make them react instead of attack.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Spiller takes it on the toss. Play number six coming up on this drive. Second down and nine. Looking across the middle.
Things get tight down here in the red area. I got to give the defensive man a lot of credit, though. In position, sees the ball thrown, and is able to get that hand up there and knock it down.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. Third and nine. He makes the catch.
Good job that time by the offense. They pick up a first down inside the 20-yard line. Now we'll see if they can punch it in and get 7 points.
The next snap will come from the 2-yard line.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one.
CJ jams it across the goal line for the touchdown.
And they continue to take that game plan that worked so well in the first half and add to it here midway through the third quarter with another touchdown, Phil.
So my answer is, what's the defense thinking? My gosh, the game plan didn't change on the offensive side, but you had no answers for it. Time to get on that sideline and figure out what you want to do.
Extra point is good.
The Saints setting up here for the kickoff. Runs up to grab it at the 4. Finds a little seam, and he's had across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Raiders talk things over at the intermission, and I'm sure one of the first orders of business was to try to figure out a way to get this offense going, Phil.
Absolutely. That's what you want to do, and I think you do that by play call. So the coach, they have many plays that we call drive starters. Catch the defense by surprise. They need to call one of those right here and right now to get this offense going.
First down at the 21. Mariota's going to take off with it. Feet first, gives himself up.
It's a rough game out there. Avoid hits at all costs. Good job that time by the quarterback sliding before he takes the hit.
From the shotgun. Going deep. Intercepted.
There have been many mistakes for this offensive unit through the first three quarters, and now they add an interception to the list.
Yeah, you make all these mistakes during a football game, you're going to lose confidence, and that's what we see right now on the offensive side. No confidence. Go back to the basics. Start all over again. That's the best thing you can do.
C.J. Spiller is in the backfield. Into the open. He's now over 60 yards rushing on the ground. They're able to move the chains after that last run.
Let's go.
Mark Ingram carries the football and picks up about three.
Ingram's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
Jim, the offensive coordinator, has done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
An extra tight end on the field for this one.
Second down and seven.
He will not get away. He's taken down for the sack.
There's a couple ways to get to the quarterback. Run over the tackle or run around him. It doesn't matter as long as you get the sack.
That big-time sack pushes him back into a third and 14. The Raiders lined up in the nickel. The Saints will set up. The 12 is the first down line. He's got the catch. That's reception number two for him.
Good job by the offense here with a good lead in the second half, picking up that first down, and that's what you want to do. Take your time, look at the play clock, take it down as low as you can, and keep picking up those first downs.
First and goal from the seven. Has his man. Picked up a couple that time.
The Raiders have speed on the defensive side, no doubt about it. And when they're backed up, they don't have to worry about players going by them because they're in the red zone. They become even faster. Way to get to the football on that throw and catch. And they stop the play for a short gain.
Let's go.
Second and goal from the five. Takes it from the strong eye.
Jim, I just want to say this to the quarterback. It's third and goal. If the play's not there, throw it away. Do not force the action.
Loss of three on the play. Breaking huddle at the 8-yard line.
Look at the defensive line shifting all down to the inside. They're pinching. They're expecting a run right up the middle.
Almost intercepted.
It's a nice play that time by the defense. The offense is inside your red zone. You've got to stop them from scoring. That was a good job of swatting the football away.
And converts on the three. We're heading into the fourth, and it looks like they've seized control of this game with that field goal.
I think they have. And you know what you do? You kick that field goal. You're looking at the clock, and you're deciding how many times can the opponent have the football? What should we do? Manage the game from here on out.
Going to take it the distance. The 30. Wilson's marked down at the 27.
There is nothing like a good return when you talk about special teams. Good blocking. The speed of the returner gets down the field. And after that tackle, now they have good starting field position.
This series begins for the offense with a very good chance to score. First down at the 27. Still powering ahead. Gurley's met after a gain of three. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day. It's now second down and seven after the 3-yard rush. The Raiders are still in possession as we get this final quarter underway. The line of scrimmage right at the 24. Quarters formation here for the defense. Final quarter underway now with this snap.
Jim, they're in the red zone, and what they have to do here is score as fast as you can so you can give yourself a few more opportunities.
Quick drop back, and that's a gain of 13.
Nice job that time by the offense getting the first down inside the red zone. And it's a good thing they got a quarterback with a strong arm because you've got to throw into some tight spots in the red zone.
So first and goal to go. They'll run it off the toss. Gurley's brought down after picking up just a yard.
Coach's going to hear about this when the game is over. Running the football in a situation like this, late in the game, you're down multiple scores. You got to take some chances. You got to throw it, and you got to throw it down the field.
Runs it across for the touchdown.
anytime the offense is near the goal line, you've got to be alert for the quarterback moving and trying to run with the football. Nobody on the defense is watching the quarterback, and he just scrambles in easily for the touchdown.
Talk about momentum. That turns into an 8-point trip, the touchdown and the two.
This offense and the head coach and the offensive coordinator, they're all aggressive. So, hey, well, it's not good enough just to get a touchdown. They want to get that extra point or 2 points. Nice job that time.
Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Saints really have this offense cranking, Phil. They've scored on their last two series.
You know, what we see now in the NFL, so many different ways to move an offense. Screens, run plays, power plays, trick plays. Right now, everything working on the offensive side. You see the linebackers moving? What they're trying to do is confuse the quarterback.
And they are in on Spiller after a pickup of about two. To the 2-yard carry, it sets up second down and 8.
Let's go.
Spiller's got it on the handle. Jordan's the one who made the big stop.
Raiders defensive coordinator, my gosh, he is one happy guy. Anytime you get in the backfield and stop a runner and make him lose yards, that's some good stuff.
This is third down. The Saints lined up. Everybody split out wide. Out of the shotgun. Intercepted. He's brought to a halt. This game has been out of hand for some time now, but the defense gives the offense one more chance to get some reps.
Yeah, they did that. It was a nice job. But and I know you said the game is over right now, and I just say to the offense, how do you throw that interception in a time like this? Midway in the fourth, you got the game in hand. That was really, really a bad decision.
The Raiders come to the line, and they put their receivers in a bunch formation. Very nearly intercepted. Breaking huddle at the 23-yard line. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Second and 10. He'll throw it over the middle. He'll pick up 7 this time. Down inside the red zone now, trying to score as quickly as possible.
But listen, the defense has got to know the situation here. It's okay to give up a few yards, maybe give up a completion. Just don't give them the big play that gets the quick score. Good job by the offense getting the first down in the red zone. Now it becomes tricky. Can you deceive the defense where you get a chance to get a score?
Margin for error from just outside the goal line, and that'll close the gap.
Hard to cover these tight ends when they get into the end zone because they're fast, they're nimble, and they're big. So even if you cover them, they push off and get the touchdown catches. Really creative thought process there, and the offense caught the defense by surprise.
The Saints getting set to return the kickoff. Cooks is going to start his return. They stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. The Saints just gave up some big turnover points. And let's see if they can hold on to the football this time, Phil, because we know how crucial it is. We talked to the coaches about it this week. This was their concern with this team.
Well, if you want to stay on the field, you better quit turning it over, right, Jim? That's what the coaches look. You make mistakes on the field, they're going to be forgiving to a point, but you got to be smart, you got to be efficient, and get the job done.
And it's now second down and 5 after running it on first down. The clock's really become a factor here, and the defense knows it has to get off the field as soon as possible to give the team a chance. Ball is out, and the defense has it. Going to take it home for the touchdown.
What a deflating play for the offense. The defense picks up the fumble, takes it not only for a touchdown, but how long? Look at the blocks. That makes the offense lose its confidence. They're going to have a hard time coming back out on the field and making it happen.
The Raiders come out for the next possession, having reached the end zone on each of their two previous drives.
Yeah, it's been good stuff to watch, no doubt. You know, the offensive side, the offensive coordinator is right in tune with the quarterback. They're calling exactly the plays that need to be called because of the situations, and the quarterback has been hot throwing the football.
So from 2 yards out, they get it across and secure 2 extra points. The Raiders getting ready to kick it off. Cooks is running this one out. Shakes off the tackle. The Saints offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
Cooks is going to pull in the bullet pass. The Saints have counted on a familiar face today. Cooks near the top of the NFL in receiving yards, and he's been dangerous again.
Well, he's so good as a wide receiver. If you're the quarterback, when you drop back, you're always going to look his way first because what? He can get open, and when you're throwing the football, he can make the catch.
Time is running out. The game is tied, and the defense must do whatever it can to not give up a score. First down at the 43. Looking to go down the field here, connect.
Well, Jim, he had a guy open deep that time. It looked like a good throw, but just out of the reach of the wide receiver.
And now they'll try over again on second down. The game is tied, and time is a factor. From the gun. And it's batted down. Following that incompletion, it sets up 3rd and 10. The Saints will line up. First down markers right at the 47-yard line. That's a ball that should have been caught.
Late in the game, the defense has to be aggressive. They are, this time on 3rd down, tied football game late in the 4th quarter. They stay aggressive and they get it done.
The Saints will punt the football. That punt sets up the defense now in excellent position as they're able to down the football inside the 10. With the game tied and time running out, they have a lot of ground to cover to get into winning field goal range.
The Raiders.
Rubber band stacks to the ceiling, and on and on, yes, the cool stay winning. Chilling, rubber band stacks to the ceiling, and on and on, yes, the cool stay winning. Let's blow it up. I'm riding now.
stacks to the ceiling. And on and on, yes, the cool stay winning. Chilling. Rubber band stacks to the ceiling. And on and on, yes, the cool stay winning. Chilling. Rubber band stacks to the ceiling. And on and on, yes, the cool stay winning. Chilling. Rubber band stacks to the ceiling. And on and on, yes, the cool stay winning.
I'm back once again. I'm a renegade.
Getting set for today's Week 12 matchup.
I don't know which team has the better tight end, but I do know that that could very well be the difference in this game today.
Well, if you made me choose between the two, I'll tell you what. I'll just say you take one. I don't care who you take. I'll take the other one because they're both that good. They can do it all. As I say, you hear me say it every once in a while. They're all in one. That means they can do anything you want.
This game is underway. Cooks has got a chance for a return. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Saints have it at the 24. And it's swatted.
it away.
Here's a look at the Saints offense. Their rushing attack this season, nothing short of a disaster.
The shotgun formation. He's got the catch. And he's tackled down after picking up the first.
Running backs are such a big part of the pass game now in the NFL. Look at this play. Able to take a short catch and get a long gain out of it. Nice job by the running back.
First down, offense readying for the snap. From the gun. Donald takes down the quarterback.
Well, you expect defensive ends to get sacks because they come around the outside. But when you get pressure from the inside and the defensive tackle gets a sack, that's just an added bonus.
That's second down coming up.
He'll take the snap from the gun. Jarring hit that time. Knocks the ball free. And now here's the Raiders defense. The strength of this defense has been its ability to stop the rush. The pass play fails to work. And now it's third down. The Saints will look to get to the 45 to pick up a first down. He'll stand back beyond the center in the gun. Donald gets to the quarterback and makes the tackle.
Well, that time the quarterback is sacked on the third down, and that's, of course, that's bad. But the good thing is he did not try to force the football down the field and get the turnover.
That punt is going out of bounds. They are not going to allow them to return it. Gurley's lined up outside on the right. The Raiders come to the line of scrimmage and empty out the backfield. Everyone split out wide. Picks up about two. And now let's take a look at the Raiders offense. They've shown this season they're not a team that's going to run the ball very much.
The pass play picks up only two. So now it's second down and eight following the completion.
They'll go shotgun here. Into the hands of Jimmy Graham.
The Raiders do a really good job this time on offense. The quarterback throws the ball short. They pick up a few yards, and now it makes third down much easier.
The Raiders want to convert here, especially after last week's abysmal performance in third down situations.
Third and two. Gurley's handed the football. That's a gain of seven.
When it's third and short, the defensive line, you got to guess. You got to think it's going to be a run play. I don't know what they were thinking. They let the offense just push them back, and they give up the first down. Good job by the offense, though.
First and 10. Gurley's taking the handoff. Keeps his legs moving. Smith's there to make the tackle.
You want to be a running back in the NFL, I'll say this. You better be able to break some tackles. We saw multiple tackles broken that time. Good job.
That'll be second and four after the running play. The Saints defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Toss to the outside.
Gurley's tackled down at the 32. Now a look at the Saints defense. They know they need to force turnovers today, coming off a game in which they had no takeaways. Press coverage all the way. Third and four. It's into the surefire hands of Odell Beckham Jr.
When the defense is going to play safe and they don't want you to run by them, you've got to be able to throw these out routes where the receiver's cutting towards the sideline and the quarterback stick it in there.
First down here after the completion.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
And he's forced to the ground.
That's a bad job by the offense that time. There's no doubt about it. The blitz by the defense, they do not do a good job of finding out where everybody's blitzing from. They let a guy come free, and that free blitzer, or as we call them, free runners, he gets the hit on the QB and takes him down.
The Raiders will take the snap from the 30. Mariota's now going to leave the pocket and tuck it under.
If you give him the chance, he will run the football. That's what he did that time. He tucked it in there and ran up the field and got a few yards.
Third down on the way. Timeout called by the defensive unit. It'll be third down. Quarters formation here for the defense. Mariota's got it in the gun. Catch made. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
This team, one of the better tackling teams in the NFL, and they play the situation perfectly. They give up the short completion. They come up and make the tackle. Now we have a fourth down.
Tackle's made.
Well, returning punts is a tough job. It's about judgment. That time, that was poor judgment by the return man. Should have just had a fair catch and never tried to return that.
The Saints didn't get much out of that last drive, so now here they come again on offense. I'm sure they're going to be a little bit more of an urgency to the offense this time.
Well, I'll just say this to you, Jim Nance. I sure hope so. After that last drive, that was just too generic. Wasn't very well thought out, and they got to change what they're doing on the offensive side.
Got to give that defense a little credit, though, don't you?
Well, yeah, the defense did its job, but man, that was pretty easy.
The Raiders with a nickel look here on defense. Second down and 10. And it's Reggie Nelson in on that last play.
The post route, deep down the field, going towards the goalpost. It's not called enough in this league. Nice throw by the quarterback. The D-line saw something on the offense. Everybody shifting to their left.
Launches it down the field. Snags it right out of the air with one hand. One-handed catches, Bill, are becoming a thing of art.
Well, they practice it now, Jim. I think as they're growing up, you see them practice it out on playgrounds when they're in practice, and they come out here in the game, and they just make it happen. That is really, truly an incredible one.
Takes it the distance for the touchdown. They take the lead here late in the first quarter with the touchdown.
Yeah, nothing like it. Before that first quarter was up, they found a way to get into the end zone and get that score to take the lead. And, hey, that's a good feeling.
The Raiders ready to return the kickoff. They'll take it at the 20. The Raiders heading back out there on offense, hoping to improve on their last possession, which ended rather quickly with a punt.
Yeah, I think what they got to do, they got to come out and be a little more creative, get the defense off guard, make them think over there. That was too generic what they did on the offensive side. If you want to score, show some ingenuity.
What a catch by Odell Beckham Jr. That's another reception. Give him two.
Beckham's so fast, you have to back off of him. Why? Because you don't want him to run by you and go deep down the field. So that time he breaks the out route, the quarterback puts it right on target, and he makes the catch just short of the first down marker.
Mariota's 5 for 5 after that completion.
Chillin', rubber band stacks to the ceiling, and on and on, yes, the Cougs stay winning. Chillin', rubber band stacks to the ceiling, and on, yes, the Cougs stay winning. Chillin', rubber band stacks to the ceiling, and on, yes, the Cougs stay winning.
Splish, splash, my tip, bring it up.